As the country prepared to host the Non-Aligned Movement and G77 high-level summits last month, much was done to give Kampala City a facelift. Besides planting flowers and trees, road renovations and others, the Kampala Capital City Authority also ensured that the guests do not catch a glimpse of the street children. As a result, hundreds of them were picked off the streets during operations conducted alongside police and the Ministry of Gender. The Ministry of Gender reveals that at least 700 street children were picked from the streets and are currently being accommodated at Masulita Children's Village.
We are in an effort to put the city in shape. There was a drive by KCCA to reduce on the number of children who were loitering in the city, who were begging, who were being misused, some of them by very unscrupulous fellows, and these were collected and brought here.
Before the NAM summit, the number of children that were being held at Masulita Children's Village was 150 children, but as of now, the numbers have shot to more than 900 children, minus the dozens of newborns.
Here, we have received over 938 children from KCCA. But also we had children that had been rescued since last year and they have been under USO, over 118 of them, so giving that total of about 1,044 children that we had in January.
The capacity of this village, the children's village, is about 150. But during that time, over 900 children were deposited here.
Chibenge notes that the growing burden of street children in all cities and towns across the country is worrying the authorities. What is more worrying is that the majority of his children are girls coming from mainly Karamoja region.
There's a very big racket that keeps on picking these children from their home areas and districts. The biggest number is brought from Karamoja and especially from Napak, unfortunately.
In a strange occasion, the same facility is accommodating a 40-year-old mother of six who was also rescued off the streets. Eva Katushabe, a resident of Wandegeya, claims she was resting on the streets when the KCCA enforcement team hijacked and brought her to Masulita, where she has been held for several weeks. I was just feeding my baby while seated on the street. They just came and carried me to the nearby car. I asked them where they were taking me, but they told me I've been a street beggar for several years. The mother of six further claims that she had tried to engage the authorities to release her, but in vain. On the other hand, the law says any adult arrested begging on the streets should be prosecuted.
If those adults are the ones perpetrating this vice, then those adults are culpable, those adults are answerable. And I'm told those who were arrested with these children, a good number of them have already been committed.
The Ministry of Gender now appeals to all Ugandans across the country to join the authorities in the fight against child trafficking in all its forms. He also calls for a multi-sectoral approach towards the elimination of street children in all the towns and cities.
Of a long-term solution to the challenge of children disappearing and not being accounted for, children not going to school and nobody being accountable for that, children being born and not knowing what happens to them, I think the parish-based management information system will go a long way in addressing that challenge.
More than 15,000 children aged between 7 and 14 years are said to live on the Kampala streets. However, the number of street children in other cities continues to rise day by day. Rachel Nachuala, reporting for the news.